Professor Dave here. Let's talk about leaving group derivatives.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Let's go back to the SN2 reaction. We know that we have, say, an alkyl bromide. This might react with a nucleophile and do SN2. We're going to get inversion of stereochemistry, and that's going to work just fine. However, let's say we have a hydroxyl group here. If we wanted to do SN2 on this alcohol, well, that's not going to work because a hydroxyl group is not a good leaving group in a substitution reaction. And so let's say we really had our heart set on SN2 at this hydroxyl position for some reason in our synthetic pathway. We really want to do an SN2 right there. Well, what could we do? We know that we could protonate that with some acid, have it try to leave. We could try to do an SN1 reaction, but there's a lot of problems there because, number one, you're going to get competing elimination reactions. So you're going to get some alkene. You're going to have a mess in your product mixture. And number two, SN1 reactions are not stereospecific. So you're going to get a racemic mixture, and if you have a lot of stereospecific steps on your pathway, it's not going to be very good. So what we want to say is, what if there was something that we could do to this alcohol to make it receptive to an SN2 reaction? Well, actually there is, and we could turn it into something called a leaving group derivative by reacting it with one of these compounds. So let's say we react with tosyl chloride. So this is called tosyl chloride, and this right here is the tosyl group. So this is tosyl and then chloride, or mesyl chloride. This is the mesyl group right here, and then this is the trifyl group right here. And reaction of an alcohol with any of these will turn this into a leaving group derivative. So let's go ahead and take a look at the mechanism for that and then see why exactly it works that way. Okay, let's take a look at how this works. So let's take our alcohol, and remember, we really want to do SN2 with this alcohol. So let's react with tosyl chloride. Remember, tosyl chloride, this is the tosyl group over here, and then the chloride. So what can happen is that the oxygen is going to attack this sulfur atom and pop that up here. Let's just pretend that, or we're going to get rid of that proton on the way, save ourselves a step. So now we have this, we have oxygen attached to all that. Remember, this pi bond went up here, so we have the oxyanion right there. Now that oxygen can go, that lone pair can come back to regenerate that double bond, but now it might kick off the chloride. Right, so if it kicks off the chloride instead of the original part of the molecule right here, now we're here. Now this is O tosyl. We would abbreviate that as O tosyl because O, and then there's our tosyl group, right? The chloride is gone. So here's an interesting thing, is that we have completely changed the reactivity of this center by turning this from OH into O tosyl. Because before, OH was a terrible leaving group for the SN2 reaction. But now we'll look at what happens. If we have O tosyl, bromide is actually going to have no problem doing an SN2 reaction on O tosyl right there, and we will get our SN2 product with inversion of stereochemistry. Again, SN2 is stereospecific, and anything stereospecific is very useful for synthesis. And then the reason that's going to work is because when O tosyl leaves, this is O tosyl, look at all that resonance. We are going to be able to put resonance up there, resonance down there, and so remember that the leaving group ability of some group has to do with its stability once it has left. And so if that tried to leave and we had OH minus, now that's not very stable. That's a strong base. That's why OH is such a terrible leaving group. But O tosyl is a great leaving group because it's got resonance for days all over the tosyl group. And so basically we have learned that leaving group derivatives, whether we're using a tosyl group, mesyl group, trifyl group, which may be useful for very specific circumstances, whatever the case may be, a leaving group derivative is a great way to turn a hydroxyl group into a good leaving group for an SN2 reaction.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.